are going to disinfect. We have started, actually. We have our presence in all the 6 geopolitical zones. We are waiting for additional response to accelerate the disinfection of schools. That we will. Now, private schools. Usually the first mandate is on the public schools. We will continue our disinfection exercise. I know of entities that will hire people to do their own decontamination and disinfection. We are very okay with that. The only caveat in that is that they hire people that are registered and licensed by the Federal Ministry of Environment under a HERACON, the Environmental Health Officer Registration Council of Nigeria. Government, as you all know, cannot do everything all at once. But we are starting, and then we'll go and move forward as we continue. So that is for the disinfection of schools and private schools. Corona is here, and it's going to be here for a while. Life has changed and will remain changed for some time to come. We don't know exactly how long. Social distancing will remain for a while. Hygiene, well, we used to practice hygiene quite all right, but now we are at the next level of hygiene. Wearing the mask, we'll have to continue. So in schools, especially boarding schools, there will be a lot of advocacy, enlightenment, first by the management of the schools, and some, I'm sure, health professionals, especially from this ministry, environmental health officers, will help with that. Institute that as a culture in the schools so that they will continue to observe that even after we have lifted the lockdown or some easement in restrictions. So as such, it's something that will remain for a while. The ministry has a program of hygiene in schools. That is one of the functions of the environmental health officers. That used to be called environmental health officers or sanitation inspectors. It's all the same thing. Because unless the environment is healthy, the people dwelling in this environment are always at risk of one infection or another, even before corona, and will be the same thing after. So it's something that is already there, instituted, but can be increased, can be upgraded, like I said, to the next level. We have to adapt and become resilient and not let corona hold us back. We can proceed with caution, observing all the measures. And the PTF is constantly reviewing as we get new information, because this is a new virus. That is why it's called novel virus, meaning new, we don't know much about it. The World Health Organization and other disease specialists and institutions are continuously researching the characteristics of the virus, and they make the information available, and then we tell you what you need to do to stay safe. That is the objective, staying safe, even in the presence of corona. So there should be no issues or too much risk in schools, especially boarding schools. All measures will be taken, and will be taken holistically everywhere. Thank you. Airport. We have just concluded arrangement with the airport and the aircraft owners. Why it took long is because aviation is such a sensitive sector. Everything must be 100%, 200%, 300%, even 400% before aviation system can function. That's why you have some aircraft that have up to 4 engines, so that one won't stop, the others can. Because up there is no parking space. All the parking spaces are down here. So we are working, we have concluded, they have chosen the chemicals that they believe will work well and not cause any safety breaches if the chemicals are applied on the aircraft or in certain areas of the airport. Are we going to disinfect parks? Yes. Because these are all the places that we consider high risk, where you have the prevalence of a lot of people concentrated. So parks, motor parks, train stations, markets. The ministry has done hundreds of this across the country and is continuing, because there are so many places to decontaminate and disinfect. And like I said, we have started and still working on the danger zones where there is high prevalence of people.